Cool. Cheers, mate.
Thank you, Nick.
That was a slightly erratic taxi ride. So it's really early in the morning. It's currently 5:40. I had to get the first train of the day into Victoria. They got a taxi driver. Here, by the way, is Kensington Olympia on the District Line on the Tube, but is it the least served tube station on the network? I think it is. It has a rather intriguing pattern where it's served at weekends, and then the sign over there suggests that it's not served at all on weekdays, but it is. As far as I'm aware, there's 11 trains in and out of Olympia on weekdays, and I'm here this morning to catch some of them. It's the 5:44 Milton Keynes Southern train, and while that has pulled in there on platform 2, something rather magical has happened behind me over here on platform 1. The District Line's turned up.
Mark the gap between the train and the platform.
This is Olympia.
Onto the train.
The next station is Earl's Court.
Yes,
this
it is.
District Line train to Edgware Road.
Okay. Is that it? We're about to leave. And so, as we make our way around to Earl's Court, a little explanation. I'll flash a map up on screen. Olympia on the District Line has always been this weird little dogleg, this little spur service off from Earl's Court. Now, up until December, I think it was 2011, there was a regular service on a weekday. I think trains were every 20 minutes, 3 an hour, they would shuttle backwards and forwards between High Street Ken through Earl's Court and into Olympia all day, backwards and forwards. Well, the official line says today is that there's no weekday service, there's merely a weekend service only, and then sometimes there's a weekday service when certain events are on at Olympia. However, dig into the District Line timetable and there's actually 11 times that you can depart or leave Olympia. There are some trains early in the morning which basically come out of Lillybridge Depot, just over there somewhere. That's a District Line depot, and they come into Olympia to start their day service. So the train that we're on has come into Olympia from the depot. But the idea is this morning is just to ride as many trains in or out of Olympia as I can. It's going to be impossible to do all 11, but I'll see how many I can do.
The next station is Earl's Court.
So I've come out the back of Earl's Court Station, Warwick Road entrance, jumped on a bus for one stop. I'm going to walk the last little bit. It's 5:59. Now, right about now, the next train, the second train of the day, is leaving Olympia. I'm not going to make it. There's no way I could possibly catch all trains, but I should, if I just walk along the road here, be in time to catch the 6:16 in. Oh, that's very pretty. This station, of course, originally, called Addison Road. Okay, that's interesting. I've got my map here. This is my own map. If you're thinking, where does that map come from? I downloaded the District Line working timetable, and it lists the first few trains as being the 5:50, which I caught. And there's a 5:59 and a 6:16 to High Street Ken, and they then become like a Richmond train or something. They become a District Line train. I thought I'd made the 6:16. I just got chatting to the lovely driver. He was like, "Morning, mate, what are you doing?" This is the 6:25 to Dagenham East. So I don't know what happened to the 6:16 that was going to High Street Ken. Court again, I'll go out the back way again and get the bus again. What a ridiculous thing to do.
Hi,
Right, so I've got a C3 bus, just the one stop. Got to walk the rest of the way again. It's cutting it fine, but I should make the 6:45 at Olympia, which is also going to Dagenham East. And we're back at Olympia. It's 6:43, just about to take over to 6:44, and there is no District Line train in on platform one. And as the overground train was arriving, train number 001 has arrived on platform one. On the top column of the timetable is the train number. I found train number one. This is the 6:38.
The next station is Earlscourt. Change for the Piccadilly line and District Line services to other destinations.
They've changed it. It's now becoming Upminster train. So waiting at Earl's Court, my train should have gone to High Street Ken. It didn't. Loads of trains though at Earl's Court to Upminster. So many in fact that you get the great game that commuters play. There's two Upminster trains on the platform at the same time, and people stand and they try and work out by looking at the signals which one is gonna leave heading towards the city first. Okay, ended up playing my own game. The Edgware Road train came in on that platform over there, but then on this platform here, the train which has come from Olympia, that's going one stop to High Street Kensington, and it is leaving before the Edgware Road train first. Get out High Street Kent, I'll be able to see the train number on the side of the train.
All change.
Mind the gap between the train and the platform.
Really need to find out what train number this is. Yeah, I'm getting coffee. That was actually train 102, which again, if you look at the working timetable, was actually a train off of Ealing Broadway that was meant to be going to Tower Hill. So they obviously terminated, reversed it early at High Street Kensington. Interesting. Came to Edgware Road just because I got a Circle Line train. Been looking at my map as well. My map, which I shall, by the way, put in the description so you can download it if you want to see yourself when the Olympia trains run. That's a perfect example of what High Street Ken and Olympia is actually for. Platform 3 and 4 are High Street Ken, are then used, you know, to receive those trains and any other trains. If there's a hiccup on the District Line, the line controllers can use those platforms to turn trains early and get the service pattern back on track. You know, there's not meant to be a daytime Monday to Friday regular service between High Street Ken and Olympia. Having said that, there are two trains this evening, so having now been up very early, I'm going to go home, literally going to have a nap, and then come back out this evening. And I'm back. I've been home, I've had a nap. I'm at High Street Ken. It's 7:36, and look what's on platform 3. It's an Olympia train. That's interesting. We're just about to depart, and an audio announcement has come on, and the destination has now changed to an Ealing Broadway train. So they've District Line controller decided that instead of going to Olympia, it's going to go straight to Ealing Broadway. This means I have to get out at Earl's Court again. I'm on platform 4 at Earl's Court. This is the Olympia information corner, because there's a little sign here, and down here there is a timetable poster that tells you about trains to Olympia. So the 1944 got changed into an Ealing Broadway train. I'm going to go back to High Street Ken, see if the one which is here at 8:25 runs, and try and get to Olympia that way. A few fun and games at Earl's Court. There were two Tower Hill trains on platforms 3 and 4, and I was waiting for the next Edgware Road to take me to High Street Ken, when the Tower Hill train over there stayed a Tower Hill train, but this Tower Hill train, they changed into a High Street Kensington terminal.
To get to platform number 2 is to walk along the platform towards the front of this train and follow the platform around to platform number 2.
That might mean...
alternatively, there are stairs halfway up the platform.
We're coming in on platform 4.
Oh,
we've come on a platform 4. I've never arrived on a train on platform 4 before. The tube nerd inside of me just had a mini nerdgasm. Don't write nerdgasm in the comments. You can write nerdgasm in the comments. Platform 4! It's 8:15 and I'm back at HSK. It's 8:16, it's due out at 8:21 in 5 minutes. Personally, I'm just still excited I arrived on platform 4. I've never arrived at platform 4 before. That's like a little, you know, 100 things to do on the tube before you die. News, we've left High Street Ken and it's still saying it's an Olympia train. It could all change at Earl's Court. Let's find out when we get there. Okay, so we're good. The train is going to Olympia, so I will end my day in exactly the same spot where I've started it. There's two things to point out here. The reason why I'm so fascinated by the Olympia service is, of course, to do with Tube Challenge. If you're trying to do the Tube Challenge, travel to all 270 stations, you have to do Olympia because the District Line does go there. You can't use the Overground, as per Guinness World Records rules, to tick off Olympia. You also can't do a Tube Challenge at a weekend, they say. You can only do it Monday to Friday, which means that you must either get one of these limited trains or wait for an event, say like the Great British Beer Festival. It takes place in August. When I last had the record in 2013, we did it during the week that the Great British Beer Festival was on. In terms of its service, I mean, I think it's one of those things where, you know, maybe TfL want to close the station, but closing a station is, you know, a right pain in the proverbial. So they run this sort of very sparse skeleton service, and it's not really meant for passengers because, you know, it's not a regular service. So what it really does is that Olympia and HSK, they're used to actually, when TfL stopped the daily service on Monday to Friday in December 2011, it does free up paths. Paths, of course, are space which trains can take, which means that you can have a better service on other lines. And I think it meant more trains to Wimbledon and extra trains to Ealing Broadway. So there's good reasons for doing it. So you can't rely on the Olympia service, but it does mean that the service is improved on the District Line elsewhere and improves its reliability, which is a good thing. So that's the reason why. But it's fun anyway, just to come out and try and get one of the limited Olympia trains. If you're ever passing Earl's Court around 7:30 or 8:00 in the evening, pop on down to platform 1, see if you can catch a limited train to Olympia. That's it. I'm still excited about platform 4. I'm gonna shut up about that now.
The next station is Olympia, where this train turns.